Salve popolo dell'MMA e bentornati su MMA Italia. Si alzano i giri del motore, ci avviciniamo al grande evento e arrivano nuove interviste. Questa volta vi porto la traduzione di parte dell'intervista di ESPN a Dustin Poirier, fresco vincitore del secondo incontro contro Conor McGregor. Come sempre un like e il benvenuto, vi lascio alla visione, ci vediamo, ciao!
Well, Dustin, thanks for having us down here at Fort Lauderdale. You just worked out, did a boxing session, and you say you're tired, which, I mean, you're in the middle of a long camp, which is understandable, but it looks like you're enjoying this, man. It still looks like you're enjoying the process of preparing for a fight, even after all these years.
I know it comes along with getting ready for these fights, and especially one of this magnitude is the hustle, the grind, the day in, day out, work ethic, and that's what I prepared for, so that's what we're doing now. You know, it's just how to stay in love with that through all the years. Big fight after big fight. How do I find different ways to approach these fights and keep it fun and refreshing for me, you know? And that's what we do.
So have you done it for this one? Have you kept this one fun and refreshing?
I've gone about it like a different fight. Like, it's not a trilogy fight for me. Just as the rematch wasn't a rematch, it was a completely different fight. Even though this fight is happening in the same calendar year, it's a completely different fight. Mm. And that's how I'm looking at it.
So you said that the way you've kept it fresh is that it's not a trilogy fight. You're approaching it as
any kind
of fight. Yeah. Is that hard though? Because you know the guy, you know that you know him personally now. You know him in the octagon. So is it hard to be in here and kind of pretend like you're fighting for a new guy when it's a guy that you're familiar with at this point?
It's the same guy, the same face, but with what comes with that, you know, the fighting style, how he's going to switch it up and try to counter what I'm going to do and make adjustments. It's all new and it's all a scramble. And really, we don't know 100% until we get in there and start moving around, and then I have to auto-regulate the actions and my defense and everything. That's the beautiful thing about fighting.
Do you like being in here and hitting this heavy bag? And, like, I'm sure that you can picture him really well because it was only 6 months ago that you guys fought. Like when you're working out in here and you're drilling, are you really seeing him and kind of feeling his movements? Or is that, like, you can't get that from 7 minutes of a fight?
No, I know the way he moves. You know, I have a even better feel of his timing. His speed, his accuracy, which the guy is good at a lot of things, man. He really is. He's special. And I felt it again in January when we fought. His timing, his willingness to put himself in harm's way to land shots is all attributes you have to go out there and finish guys the way he does. And I respect that because I have the same, I don't want to curse in this interview, but don't care mentality. At times when I'm in there, I'll risk it all to land a big shot. And that's the kind of fights I want to be part of and put on shows. And somebody's going to fall, you know. That's just the fight business.
One of the kind of fun things about a trilogy is just to see how the sort of relationship or the dynamic between the two fighters changes. How would you describe it, you know, first fight, second fight, and then what is it going into this third fight?
I think the first fight, I was a bit more established with the American UFC fans, you know. I had a few wins, a couple good wins. Had gone on streaks before in Zuffa, and he was the up-and-coming guy who had a lot of hype and didn't have that big staple win in his UFC career yet. And I was that guy, unfortunately. A stepping stone on his rise to stardom, to the celebrity and superstar Conor McGregor that he became to be. You know, I was part of that history, and looking back, that sucks for me to be that position, but at the same time, it's beautiful because that's what life's about, man. Things go full circle, and then we meet again, you know, years and years later after he has become the two-time, you know, two-division world champion, and I put my hand on interim gold. Just a good fighting story, mm-hmm. You know.
And so what is the dynamic now with this fight?
It's me trying to show that January wasn't a fluke. Him trying to show that he's still relevant, that he still wants to be the world champion at 155 pounds, you know. Because I was pushing to fight at a heavier weight, and I wanted to fight 170. I didn't want to cut down to 55 again. But he wants to do it at 55. UFC wants it at 55, so I know what that means. That means the winner of this fight is fighting for the belt.